And you know, that political experience will no doubt come in handy for Republican Ted Gatzis as he will now preside over a board of aldermen in Manchester where the Democrats hold a supermajority. And you add to that a spending cap that Manchester voters also approved yesterday for the city, and there will likely be no shortage of work.
Thank you.
On the day after the election, the Manchester native could be found on the streets of his city, both appreciative and eager to get to work.
We're going to work very hard to move this community forward. I've already set up meetings starting next week to meet with all the aldermen-elect so that we can sit down and have a conversation.
And those conversations will no doubt focus in large part on the tax and spending cap also approved by voters in Manchester on Tuesday. Gatzis has spent much of his time in Concord arguing for fiscal restraint, but he says a spending cap cannot infringe on the growth of the airport or impair Manchester's ability to borrow.
It's about restricting spending, because low spending means low taxes, and we've got to try and live within our means. People today, it's a very difficult time in the economy. People are sitting at kitchen tables, working very hard to live within their means. We as a city must do the same thing.
And while Gatzis will replace fellow Republican Frank Ginta as mayor of Manchester, the state Democratic Party isn't exactly dwelling on the loss.
We picked up two mayoral seats, essentially wiped the Republicans out of office on the Board of Aldermen, the school board in Manchester, picked up two additional city councils. I think it was a terrific night, and I'm looking forward to 2010.
Well, Ted Gatzis has managed to win the Manchester mayor's race with almost 57% of the vote, which is a larger total than his predecessor Frank Ginta garnered in his previous two elections. Gatzis will be sworn in as mayor on January 1st, but at this point it's still unclear exactly when he will resign his seat in the state Senate. Reporting live, Josh McKelvin, WMUR News 9.